This is an exclusive premiere for you of the BMW M8 Grand Coupé. We'll take you on a tour, exterior, interior, and also the performance features here on Autogefühl. Let's go. Please subscribe if you haven't done so far to get all the news of the latest car premieres. Here, the front of the BMW 8 Series in general has this big front double kidney, very horizontally drawn, together with the headlamps, which come standard with LED, optional those laser lights, then with the blue accentuations. And the M8 has some stronger lower bumpers right there, and also more open front grille right there for more cooling power and also more aggressiveness in the design. The carbon roof comes standard with the M8. However, this car here is optionally equipped with the additional carbon fiber package, which then also includes some more carbon fiber accentuations, for example, here in the front and also over the rest of the vehicle. 5m08, 16'8" or 200 inches is the length of a normal BMW 8 Series as Grand Coupé. And here in the M8, well, maybe a little bit different because of the overhangs of the spoilers, but basically the same. This one here, the Grand Coupé, is the four-door coupé of the 8 Series and will be the most significant in their lineup. Well, the M8 will of course not be bought in very high numbers, so that's a very exclusive version and sumo also to the power. Here in the side profile you can see the normal M8 started with 19 inch. The competition, which is this car, that's the M8 Competition Grand Coupé or M8 Grand Coupé Competition, however you want to put it, 20 inch wheels, the biggest one available, massive style here in the black. Then again, those additional carbon fiber accentuations. Also, we have special side mirrors here also with more aerodynamic features, and again with this carbon fiber cover. Then the carbon fiber roof, as I said, is standard for the M8. Well, reduces a little bit of the weight, but is more definitely for the visual part. Wine red like color here. This is one of the individual colors. Pretty spectacular also for that one, but I think a more screaming out color would even fit better to an M8, or what's your take on that? The general design of the Grand Coupé, of course, here with the additional door and also the long roofline right there, very strong shoulders, and also this glass that is put a little bit lower than the outside pillar of the car. Overall, I think a very sleek design. So the length of the car is not really that visible. It looks sleeker than it actually is. Difference to the normal 8 Series Grand Coupé here with the M8 is this additional carbon fiber spoiler right there. Then also the M8 Competition badge, as this one said, the competition model. And of course, massive rear diffuser carbon fiber. And then this four pipe exhaust, real exhaust pipes, and extremely massive, of course, to boost that sound. And speaking of technology details, the 8 Series comes with an adaptive suspension, so no air suspension available, but you also don't need it because the adaptive suspension is actually quite cool, both comfortable and sporty. However, here in the M8, it has a way sportier setup, way stiffer setup, so we'll see how that one plays out as for the comfort. And a normal 8 Series Grand Coupé would offer a rear axle steering to give you some more agility. However, they did not go for that one in the M8 because I said it doesn't fit to our rather purist concept. It is, however, based on all-wheel drive, so rear plus front on demand. But the same way as the M5 all-wheel drive works, you can set it to an all rear-wheel drive. So it's an adjustment thing. So in the sportiest mode, then you can get to rear-wheel drive only. You can deactivate all of the assistance systems. And then it's, again, purest rear-wheel driven car. And you can also get rid of all electronic helpers on demand if you like it. And by the way, difference from the normal N8 M8 and the M8 competition is. You have a little bit different inclination from the front wheels on the front axle. You have a modified rear axle as well. So, and also those, you know, bigger wheels. So those are some differences together with a little horsepower difference from the M8 and M8 competition we'll talk about right now. So what's powering this thing? It's a 4.4 liter V8. Base same engine as in the M850i, the M performance model, but here the true M model then comes not with 530, but here then with either 600 or in the M competition with 625 horsepower. And the acceleration figure is about 3.5 seconds to 100 kilometers or 62 miles an hour. Of course, very, very powerful. As I said, rear-wheel drive only possible, but all-wheel drive is the standard setup, mated to a converter automatic gearbox. Then, was also interesting right here, the color is Ametrin Metallic. This one is the individual color code and it's also here on the badge under the hood. Pretty interesting. And now I'll put the microphone behind the car next to the exhaust. I will rev it up here once, first in the normal mode, and then I'll activate the special exhaust valve and we can see how the difference plays out in the sound. Also get the big display key for this car. Oh, 6 kilometers range, hardly any fuel in that car, it seems. So, and let's get inside. Put your finger right there to close it, hand inside then to open the car again with the keyless entry. Door closing sound is of course not the best with those coupe cars because there are no frames around, but then again it's an advantage to get in and out, of course, and it's more sensual design, definitely. And here, everything wrapped tightly, then abundance of animal skin use, sadly, in this vehicle. They don't offer any alternatives for the 8 series. Hofmeister Kink design, optional Bausen Wilkins sound system, really crisp and crystal clear sound. Door pockets are rather slim. Then with the illuminated M8 competition badge for the competition model. Well, if you go for the M8 or the competition, it won't make such a difference, honestly. So, and then there's the special M interior. You can already see at the steering wheel. The most significant thing are those two red knobs or buttons, and M1 and M2. And those are your hotkeys for your personal M mode for whichever setting you like for the electronic stability control, how you want the steering wheel, how you want the suspension, and so on. Or if maybe like you put M1 that you get directly to the rear-wheel drive only mode, or you put it to M2, so you can configure that yourself. That's the thing. Also M colors at the inside of the steering wheel, and then a special M seat, which has a little bit more side support there, and even more animal skin use. But what I found quite nice are those, you know, color accentuations right there, and there is this special M badge here. Should also be illuminated, but it's not at the moment. And in the middle console, you can also see there's this red start-stop engine knob or button. And then there's the shifting lever, which also has the contrast switches and special buttons. We are soon going to show you where you can then adjust those buttons at the steering wheel. So a little bit more individualization for your personal racing style. So I get inside. And of course, you sit a little bit lower in this car in general, but it doesn't feel too much different than the normal 8 series Grand Coupe as for the seating position and as for the ride height and so on. So I always think that the comfort should be a little bit better in those 8 series cars just from the seat ergonomics. Maybe it's just a personal thing, but you have to try it out yourself considering the length of the car, you know, the oval dimensions. You don't have too much space here in the interior. Everything is very voluminous also from those consoles. Headroom. There's of course no panoramic roof in here since we have the carbon fiber roof, and then That still leaves some headroom above my head here, but to the side, of course, due to the flat A-pillar, it comes somewhat close, definitely. You can adjust the seat electronically as well as the steering wheel, so you can find a good position here. And of course, very important, the manual shifting pedals here, always very well reachable. And they also give you a very nice feedback. So if you want to take this car on the racetrack from time to time, yeah, maybe that's not that realistic for this car, because it's, yeah, I mean, base 8 series Grand Coupe about 90k at least, and then this one, I mean, 165 something, and with some extras probably then end up having double the price. And yeah, that's of course a price region which is already quite ridiculous, isn't it? Interior overview: left side digital instruments, 12.3 inch, head-up display standard. Then right side 10.25 inch screen, also standard, so most of that stuff is then included at least. Then steering wheel here again, you see those mode buttons. I will soon show you how you can set them. When you set it on the central infotainment screen, then you can adjust the stuff, and then you have to hold the buttons, and after a while there's a beep sound like this, and then the setting is saved, and then you can switch around however you would like to have it. Really good size and also grip for the steering wheel. Then this huge middle console right there, LED ambient lighting is also nicely done. This climate unit, you can control it while driving still and adjust it like this. I like to be able to do that, also to switch off or on the AC, because, you know, sometimes I also like to switch off or on AC while driving, not go deep in the menu or something. Metal knurling around the volume knob, that's also nicely done. And there are different controls for the infotainment system, either via touch, so that's possible, or then with the lower central control knob, as we used to, or then also with the voice control, for example, "Hey BMW, what's the weather?"
"Currently it is cloudy in Putimao with a temperature of 22 degrees.
"Thank you very much, car." So, and controlling the temperature then in the car, or GPS destination input, that is also one of the best user cases. Smartphone will be connected either via Bluetooth, or you can also add the Apple CarPlay, also wirelessly, but Android Auto is not available. The map actually here is pretty fast, also good, you know, control of the screen like that, and you will very well see where you are actually heading to. So that's well done. And then the car menu also has some special settings for the M driving mode. But here, for example, I want to show you, you can also set different interior lightings here. You can set the ambient lighting all the way up, and also can change to a more, you know, blue color, for example. Then we can also see it at the inside of the doors. Can you pick that up, Jonas? Here on the right side of the Bowers & Wilkins sound system, that looks pretty amazing, right? When it, like a turbine style of the blue at the inside of the speakers, together with the rest of the blue ambient light, that is pretty cool feature, right? Really nice. So yeah, I like ambient lighting in cars and interior, that's cool. I'll soon show you the M setup. Let's first show you here the M8 competition badge in the lower end. Yeah, a lot of black piano lacquer is being used right here then. Don't like it that much, but they have an inductive charging pad here in the front, USB-A connecting device, in the adaptive cup holders, and then there's the special M shifting lever, a little bit crisper than the normal one, and also not this crystal, so crisper, but not crystal, indeed. Then here you can also set the suspension, stiffer or softer, and red start-stop engine button. This then again is this MMI knob. Yeah, I know MMI it's called, or it was called at Audi, but still sometimes we call it that way. Some hotkeys for map and so on. And now it gets even more interesting. We have an exhaust button to put that one more, you know, a little bit louder with the exhaust valve. Then you have the M mode button. So when you press the M mode button, this is rather about the assistance systems. So, and when you then check it up in the infotainment screen again, it changes. If you're on the road, all assistance systems active. Sport, with a little bit, you know, sportier driving available, so the ESC rules later and so on. And then when you hold it, this button, then you can get to the track hold. Let's say track hold, yeah. No, so, oh, sorry, the M mode, and then hold it. So sport, and now it should switch over. Yeah, there it is. So, and now everything could be deactivated if the car would be running, if the engine would be running and everything is deactivated. And that brings us back then here to the button that is below that, the setup button you can get right there. And here you can make your individual M settings, how you want to have it. And as soon as you're finished, for example, you want like a sportier steering, or you want a stiffer chassis, or like the suspension, or then you want to, you know, when they put the ESC off, M dynamic mode is what would be the first step, so it's a little bit more rear bias. Or when you then hold the ESC button, then you can get to this two-wheel drive only mode. There we go, ESC off. And then this one is also available for switching. And when you then hold one of the steering wheel buttons, then you can have this exact configuration on your, maybe you heard the sound, on your M2 button at the steering wheel. So that's the way you set up your M driving experience then for your car. Yeah, pretty interesting. I think it's also quite intuitive to use. I think a very nice addition that they used it in that way. So, and two more things about this interior. When we pan a little bit up to this back mirror here, frameless, nice integration, beautiful. And above that, those BMW wings. I hope they don't flicker on camera at the moment. They do not in real life. And, you know, this is a very beautiful design, definitely still here. And on the other way around, this is then the last thing about the front interior today, because there's still an armrest in the middle console coming up. Yeah, way to go. Jonas is the panning master for today. So here we go. And there's USB-C supply and also actually reasonable space and some rubber material on the ground. That stuff in there doesn't fly too much around. And I think that's very important, because with this car, yeah, there will be a lot of corners to catch. Digital instruments. This is the normal mode. There you have the GPS in the middle and the RPMs go counterclockwise. Jonas can rev it again. Yes. He always likes to do that, because here it's better when Jonas sits on the driver's side to be able to film that. And when you go to the M mode and go to the sport mode, then you have a special M visualization here for the M8 Grand Coupe. So, you know, more focused on the speed and the RPMs. And then it also looks different, because on both sides, the RPMs rev up. The head display also has a special M visualization where it has this RPM focus. Jonas, do you want to rev it here as well, the head-up display? Yeah, way to go. Nice. And then, of course, the speed and the allowed speed and so on. And there will also be GPS direction information in the head-up display, if you like. An 8 Series 2-door coupe can be rather just used in the front for the front passengers and maybe emergency seats in the rear. But here you actually have four full seats. There's even a fifth one possible, theoretically. Theoretically rather. But here, in the rear, you can see you can actually also fit four tall adults in here. And just take a sample. Legroom-wise, no problem. It's not the most comfortable seating position here. A little bit caged in as well. And headroom, it directly works with my 1.86 m or 6'1". But that's about it. Directly works. But, you know, that's indeed it. So you can get along right here. Can also take it as a family vehicle, so to say. But you have to be sure of the limitations. I really like those M seat belts here with the M colors, definitely. And the bright interior is also, you know, nice if you compare it to an all black interior. You can theoretically also sit in the middle seat here, but just for, you know, a shorter period of time, because this very, very thick middle tunnel, where also carbon fiber is on the chassis being used to increase the torsional stiffness. And then two USB supplies here, USB-C, and a separate climate unit also for the rear seats. That's also another option. You can also get the seat heating for the rear seats. But even with this super expensive car, they still reserved some options for that. Manufacturers always like to take the top horsepower spec cars to the racetrack and show off there. But yeah, I mean, you can test the capabilities of the car. But most people will buy this car and still use everything the car has to offer, for example, also the trunk. And for this coupe style, you can see it's still very well usable. Of course, again, exterior versus interior dimensions, it's not the best package, but still you can get along with, you know, with this height, about 50 centimeters in height. And you can also flip the seats if you want to transport some longer things. This middle part, you could also be flipped individually as a ski hatch. So at least you're a little bit flexible still here. And now to the conclusion for today with the BMW 8 Series Grand Coupe S M8 Competition. Of course, abundance of power right there, more than you could possibly ever need. The V8, in comparison to the six-cylinder engine, of course, increases the weight on the front axle. So with our test rides with the 8 Series cars, we actually felt that the six-cylinder is even a little bit better because it has a little bit more weight than on the front axle. And the entry-level version, the 840i, also offers rear-wheel drive. And the other possibility would indeed be then going for the M8, because then you can have the rear-wheel drive on demand with this special function. So probably it's then either go for the lower spec or go for the higher spec to be still able to get that rear-wheel drive, because I really felt then also with test driving the 840i, which you can tune into the full review, that yeah, rear-wheel drive fits the car very well and makes it also a little bit more agile. Yeah, no rear axle steering here for that car. I can really understand the decision, but for a normal everyday driving customer, that would also definitely be pretty cool. This one here will be way stiffer from the suspension as for the riding comfort. So of course you will lose some comfort with this car, but if you buy the M8, you want that stiff sportiness, also more aggression in design, even more so than with the competition pack, which adds, you know, a little bit more precision to the steering feeling, for example, but there won't be a big difference between the M8 and the M8 competition. Interior, you still somewhat have a usable car, have enough space also at the rear seats, but if you consider the overall package, the 8 Series Grand Coupe does of course not offer so much interior as the exterior length would promise. That's the thing, that it's rather a design object and definitely a very elegant one on the exterior. Way sportier and a little bit less elegant than here in the M8 trim, but overall still, I think, you know, that's the number one purpose of this car, to be a design object. On the interior, of course, we would expect, especially for the sportiest version, that we have some fabric or Alcantara seats also to give a little bit more friction than when seating and being agile in the corners. So that's not a good decision in many ways they put in here in this very vehicle. So that is our overview for today, exterior and interior. And of course, at a later stage, we'll also take that one out to the track. Even if, you know, the normal customer of this car probably will not ever take it out to the track, but rather enjoy the performance on the motorway or something, we will, of course, show you what it is maximum capable of then at a later stage. Thank you so much for tuning in today. Stay subscribed to keep up that we can keep you updated with the latest premieres here, exterior, interior, and of course, our extensive driving reviews. Thanks and see you next time.